Good morning, CMS. I have some new arrivals I want to go over with you for the beginning of December, even though today's the last day of November. Here's a new one, Melissa De La Cruz, Something in Between, Only You Can Decide Where You Belong. Dad opens the envelope slowly. Mom leans over his shoulder. They are completely silent as they read the letter. I expected my father to jump from the table and hug me and my mother to scream, but neither of them say anything. In fact, they look like they just received the worst kind of news instead of the best news ever. What's going on? So typical of Melissa De La Cruz style, keeping you on your toes. So this is a heartwarming book of love, identity, ambition, the American dream. Also has a lot of hope. Some of the reviews discuss that. This is another R.L. Stine. She's writing more young adult books with horror and suspense. This is called The Dead Boyfriend. She's dying to go out with him. So she's back together with her boyfriend. It was perfect. And she has some kind of blackout after seeing him with another girl and he's dead. And she doesn't know what happened, but she's seeing him across a room at a party. Is it a ghost? So in typical R.L. Stine fashion, a nice horror. Nice? I don't think that goes together. A horror ghost story. Here's a book called Endangered by two-time Edgar Award-nominated Lamar Giles. Her name is Lauren, but everyone calls her Panda. And she has a photo blog that all of her classmates are addicted to because she reveals secrets about her classmates and peers. And no one knows that she's behind the blog until she gets a note that threatens to reveal her identity unless she plays a little game of dare or dare. So again, a suspense novel. This is by Jeff Strand. It's called The Greatest Zombie Movie Ever. And he writes humor stories. And this is about a group of guys and friends that make these horrible YouTube movies. And this time they're making one about killing zombies. They don't have a lot of money, but they do get a popular girl to star in the film and things just go crazy wrong. And there's a lot of humor. One Was Lost, Natalie Richards, author of 6 months Later and Gone Too Far. This is another suspense book. And someone was here, we were sleeping and they were in our tent. So this sounds a little Blair Witch-ish to me. Oh God, my heart trips itself and then races. What happened to us, Lucas asks. They did it to you too, Emily says. We all turn to her, the word is different. What? He turns his left wrist up. We all see the letters like a tattoo, deceptive. Emily says damaged. Lucas checks his and it says dangerous. I turn and my word is darling. So they're trapped in the woods after a flash flood on a senior field trip. They couldn't, and they have supplies. They're staying in the woods, and someone else is there with them that has not revealed himself or herself. So another suspense book for full suspense. This one is called Sophomores and Other Oxymorons, and this is a companion to Sleeping Freshmen Never Lie, if you read that book. And School Library Journal calls this hilarious. Scott's physical and emotional tumult is as clear, familiar, and complex as high school itself. So the reviews talk about accurate observations about freshman life, first dates, the dangers of walking the hall between classes, and just what it's like to be a teenager. So getting away from suspense, we have another humor book to go along with Jeff Strand. Three More Words. This is on my to-read list. This is by the author Ashley Rhodes Corder. She had an award book on the list a few years ago called Three Little Words, and it was one of our first memoirs that I can remember being on the award book list. And so it's a true account of her life in the foster system in Florida. And her abuse in the foster system actually propelled the state of Florida to change their laws. And it was an excellent book, detailed some horrors of moving from foster family to foster family. And this girl kind of fell through the cracks. So this is Three More Words. So it's more about her life and everything that she's done to improve the foster system in Florida and throughout the country. It was a really good book. When I finished the first one, I actually looked her up, and she's just a remarkable teenager that overcame a lot of obstacles, went to college, wrote these novels, and is helping a lot of people. So here's a book, Jennifer Donnelly. She wrote a former award book, Revolution, which I enjoyed 2 or 3 years back. And so this one is about a rich girl getting ready to graduate from finishing school. She's going to be married off to a wealthy bachelor. It's not really what she wants. But then her very wealthy father is found dead while cleaning a revolver. And he's a much too smart man to leave a loaded gun and accidentally shoot himself while cleaning. So this is her way of, she tries to figure out what really happened to her dad and starts to uncover some things that she didn't know. So another suspense. Marissa Meyer, Heartless. I know a lot of people have waited for this. Catherine may be one of the most desired girls in Wonderland and a favorite of the unmarried king, but her interests lie elsewhere. So this is in the Lunar Chronicles, is what Marissa Meyer wrote. So if you liked those, you might want to start this series by Marissa Meyer called Heartless. And it actually is a new series. Suicide Notes from Beautiful Girls. So this is another suspense mystery. They say Delia burned herself to death in her stepfather's shed. They say it was suicide, but June doesn't believe it. So June and Delia were best friends. Everything came before guys, before family, and they had a lot of secrets. And then some pranks got out of hand, and now one is dead. And June is certain she was murdered, and it's up to her to try to find the truth. So full of suspense today. Here we have The Hammer of Thor, which is by Rick Riordan, the series Magnus Chase. So if you're reading that series, here's the newest installment. This book, All in Pieces. And I'm trying to remember why I put this one in the list. That's how they classified. Oh, this is a girl who stuck a pencil in her ex-boyfriend's hand because he made fun of her little brother who is mentally disabled. And they sent her to like a temporary detention center, alternative school. And it's miserable. And she learns a lot about herself, her family. Everything's messed up. A new guy comes in with problems, love, custody, breaking out. So there's a lot with All in Pieces. Here's a new biography about Prince. And we have some people in the school who are huge, huge fans of Prince. So I wonder if he'll come down to check this out and read about his life. So if you followed Prince and want to know more about his life after he died tragically or too soon, we have that biography. Finding Audrey. This is about a girl. This is what old age does to you. I can't think of what it's called. She won't go outside. She stays in the house all the time, wears glasses. Her brother has a new friend that kind of pulls her out of her shell a little bit. So, and they fall in love. So that's what that book is about. And then, I don't know anything about this aside from the reviews, and I love the cover, and it's called Homeroom Diaries. And this is James Patterson. And so he's written more, books for young adults than ever lately. And, this is about a girl who's kind of a little crazy. She's been in the psych ward, but she's determined once she gets back into school to make her life positive and happy. So lots of good books and several that I didn't even go over and a lot more on order for December. So I hope you'll come down to the library, check these out, and get some good reading for all that snow we might have this winter. Have a great day.